Hello everyone, to have a background image within a button, all you need to have is a background image inside of a drawable folder. Suppose you have named it as btn_bg. So go to your activity_main.xml where you have defined your button and introduce a property inside it, which is Android background equals to, within inverted commas, write down add drawable, defining the path. You'll find btn_bg and make it my button's background. Similarly, to have a button with a border, I'll introduce you all to shape drawable. That is, in drawable folder, form an XML file, suppose border.xml, with the shape tags, shape and the closing one. In between will be two tags which are self-closing, the first one being solid for the color, which is red. So Android color will inherit it, the red color which is inside the button, and the stroke tag in here. Using the Android color and Android width, we'll give it a border, a black border. So once your border.xml has been formed in the drawable folder, simply go into the activity main where your button has been described, and inside the Android background property, just simply write in add drawable slash border, like any other image asset that you define the drawable with, the Android background property with. So in a similar manner, we'll describe a border.xml also. So let's get started with the coding. Welcome to the coding arena. This was the linear layout that we were working with in the previous video. I have just closed it up and made another linear layout that we'll be working with. I've given it a width of match parent, a height of also match parent, a padding of 16 dp and orientation of vertical, and introduced a new background color, which is tan 2, that I've defined in the colors.xml file previously. So now we'll be forming two buttons in this video. So let me make it for you. So this is my button with a wrap content as my layout width and also a wrap content for the layout height. I'm quickly gonna give it a padding of 10 dp like we have given it previously, of 10 dp, and a layout gravity to be set to center horizontal. And now we are all done. Let me also give it a text of button with a background image. Now in my drawable folder over here, I have a btn_bg.png as my file that I wanna have as my background of this button. So I'm simply gonna go into my button and type in background and specify the path as drawable button_bg. But I see that this has far more huge dimensions and it's not fitting enough with the button. So I'm just going to reduce my layout height to 50 dp. You people can work with decreasing the dimensions of the button that you're going to work with, because having a height in dp is not a good practice. So I'm changing also the text color so that it becomes visible, and I'm going to type in Android color as white, and yay, we have a button with a background image. Now I'm gonna be forming the second button, so let me just close it, copy this, and I'm gonna paste it over here. So when I opened it up, I'll simply change the text which says button with a border, and let me remove this background property. Now go into your drawable folder over here and right click on it, go to new, and then go to drawable resource file. I will name mine as border, click on OK, and when you shall go into the text section, you will see a tag like selector. So what does selector do? Selector will actually let you form items of various categories, like when the button is pressed, focused, hovered, selected, checkable, enabled, activated, etc., etc. But at this moment of time, we are only interested in working with the shape tag. So either you can do like that, let me just undo it. So either you guys can make an item over here, close it, and now inside this you can form your shape and it won't be a problem. But if you people directly want to be working with the shape tag, that's also fine. I prefer this. And once it has been formed, just type in the shape property of Android. So this XML and S prologue will pop up on its own. So as you can see, the shapes are rectangle, ring, they are also line, oval, etc. So because it is a button, I shall choose the shape as rectangle. So this is a compulsion. But if you don't even write this by default also, it is treated as a rectangle. The Android shape by default is rectangle. So now we shall be working with the solid tag. And give it a space and then just press slash. So this will do the trick for you. Now I shall type the color property of Android and keep it as Android color dark, red dark. So this will give the background color to the button, but we are also interested in giving the border. So for that, use the stroke, give it a space, a forward slash, and then give it a color. I'll be using the color black over here, but nothing has remarkable has popped up over this side in the design palette. That's because the width property is missing. So to show you all, I'm just giving it a width of 12 dp, and yes, it's working as you can all see. But for the button, we shall use the width as 2 dp. So we are all done. Our border.xml has been formed with the solid color and with the stroke color and width. So I'll go back to my activity main.xml and give it a background property of @drawable, simply slash border. And here comes a button ready with the border. So please try it on your own, and I hope it helped. Thank you for watching.